running an economy based on wind. I never understood wind. You know, I know windmills very much. I've studied it better than anybody. I know it's very expensive. They're made in China and Germany mostly. Very few made here, almost none. But they're manufactured tremendous, if you're into this, tremendous fumes, gases are spewing into the atmosphere. You know, we have a world, right? So the world is tiny compared to the universe. So tremendous, tremendous amount of fumes and everything. You talk about the carbon footprint, fumes are spewing into the air, right? Spewing. Whether it's in China, Germany, it's going into the air, it's our air, their air, everything, right? So they make these things, and then they put them up. And if you own a house with a vision of some of these monsters, your house is worth 50% of the price. They're noisy. They kill the birds. You want to see a bird graveyard? You can just go. Take a look. A bird graveyard? Go under a windmill someday. You'll see more birds than you've ever seen ever in your life. You know, in California, they were killing the bald eagle. If you shoot a bald eagle, they want to put you in jail for 10 years. A windmill will kill many bald eagles. It's true. And you know what? After a certain number, they make you turn the windmill off. That's true, by the way. They make you turn it off. And yet, if you killed one, they put you in jail. That's okay. But why is it okay for these windmills to destroy the bird population? And that's what they're doing. Okay. This is a conservative group, Dan. Am I right? I'll tell you another thing about windmills. And I'm not, look, I like all forms of energy. And I think, really, they're okay in industrial areas, like you have an industrial plant, you put up a windmill, you know, et cetera, et cetera. I've seen the most beautiful farms, most gorgeous things you've ever seen. And then you have these ugly things going up. And sometimes they're made by different companies. You know, I'm like a perfectionist. I really built good stuff. And so you'll see like a few windmills made by one company, General Electric. And then you'll see a few made by Siemens. And you'll see a few made by some other guy that doesn't have 10 cents, it looks like. So you see all these windmills are all different shades of color. They're like sort of white, but one's like an orange white. My favorite color, orange. And they're all, and you know what they don't tell you about windmills? After 10 years, they look like, you know, they start to get tired, old. You got to replace them. A lot of times people don't replace them. They need massive subsidy from the government in order to make it. It's really a terrible thing. And what they want to do is they want to get rid of all petroleum products. That means you basically want to have factories in the United States. So tell me, though, how are you going to win Texas when you say, we're going to get rid of all petroleum? He was a beauty. Beto came out, he's from Texas. He came out against religion, he came out against guns, and he came out against energy, oil, right? So he's against oil, guns, and the Bible. Abraham Lincoln can't win with that platform in Texas, I can tell you. No, we're doing it right. We're doing it right. And you know, our numbers environmentally right now are better than they've ever been before, just so you know. Because I'm an environmentalist. I am. I want the cleanest water on the planet. I want the cleanest air anywhere. Crystal clean water. I want perfectly clean air. And we have the best numbers right now that we've ever had, meaning in the last 40 years.